from the Imus in Washington Network Newsroom.
I'm David Brinkley, the mildly acerbic host of this program and This Week with David Brinkley, seen on ABC Television Sundays.
And I'm Walter Cronkite, Basil Fossil, who once had my own show, till squeezed out by Dan Rather.
And I'm Don Imus, an object of loathing for 20-odd years in New York, soon to be an object of loathing from coast to coast. Now the news.
However, before we get to this morning's program, here are some late-breaking developments since the Sunday papers.
Sunday?
In Washington, a startling, if not unexpected, turn of events. Every woman ever associated with the Clinton administration is either en route to the flood-stricken Middle West or making hasty preparations to leave as soon as possible. The president, just back from an inspection tour of the flooded area, addressed himself to this latest crisis, the loss of all his female appointees and aides, moments ago at the White House.
In retrospect, I shall use different terms in describing the flood situation and what's needed out there. Knowing the women I've brought into my administration, I should have said levees needed reinforcing, not dikes needed plugging. I should have known better, and I take full responsibility for what's happened. Largely because I can't find Janet Reno anywhere. Hillary, have you seen Janet Reno? Hillary? Has anybody seen Hillary?
Meantime, risking fierce criticism and further erosion in public confidence, it's been learned that the president has decided to abandon his nomination of controversial Surgeon General designate Jocelyn Elders. The White House has not made a formal announcement as yet, but Maryland Congressman Kweezy Mfume, chairman of the Black Caucus and an Elders supporter, revealed that the Elders appointment was dead. He reported that Mr. Clinton had assured him three times in the past 3 days that he was totally and irrevocably committed to her nomination. Meanwhile, in medical news, researchers at Greenwich Hospital in Greenwich, Connecticut, say they are still trying to identify the glutinous material removed from the ear canals of popular radio host and one of our colleagues here, Don Imus, over the weekend.
Shut up.
While examination with an electron microscope has not pinned down the substance's components as yet, doctors report that when dried and smoked, it produced an instant and intense euphoria. When played backward, it generated a sound similar to a human speech pattern, producing the phrase, "I'm great, you suck," and caused a positive pregnancy when used to artificially inseminate what technicians described as a big old greasy laboratory rat.
Speaking of pregnancies pending, it appears marriage is in the air for the Kennedy clan. First, Congressman Joseph Kennedy II announced that he's engaged, he thinks, to Ann somebody. By his own admission, the congressman isn't on top of that many facts, but believes the lucky lady is a member of his Washington staff.
Yeah.
And even more exciting, reports say John F. Kennedy Jr. and his longtime companion, Daryl Hannah, have applied for a marriage license in California. Senator Ted Kennedy, who himself re-wed last July, expressed delight at the news.
Let me say this about that. Way to go, Joe. He's hoping the annulment comes through soon. And he's also hoping that Miss Hannah is indeed the lucky girl for John John. As she demonstrated in her hit film, Splash, she certainly is quite a looker and also quite a swimmer. Neither is an inconsequential consideration when marrying into the Kennedy family.
Wait a minute.
Anybody got any Bushmills over here? Bartender, can I get a drink, please?
I'm in the morning.
Mm-hmm. Maggot lip
honk. Narrow shoulder.
They're going to have women in here taking clothes off, and it's not going to be that kind of deal. And there's an occasional penis reference, but it's only when it's important, when something comes up about a person's penis. Now, there's just a gratuitous penis references. At any rate, sports is coming up and some other stuff, and we'll talk to Warner Wolf. Now, however, the senior senator from the state of Massachusetts.
Recently, the Imus in the Morning program.
Manhattan. Of course, come on. God almighty!
Here we are with a uber sensitivity issue.
Oh,
here.
Honest please to God,
grief.
These people sitting around waiting to be offended. And then I'm supposed to roll over and bark like a fat seal for a fish because they threaten me with the FCC. The FCC is not going to do anything because there's nothing to do.
No.
And I'd be the first to admit if I thought I had gone too far. That's not even an issue here. Drunken Indian. I mean, it doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean anything in the light of professional football teams calling themselves the Washington Redskins or the Atlanta Braves and mocking what in a lot of cases are serious Indian rituals and ceremonies.
Mm-hmm.
And Native American rituals and ceremonies.
Indigenous peoples.
Yeah, that's what we're... You know, how long do you think you'd get by with it, by the way? if you wanted to call the New York Giants the New York Jews? How do you, how long, or the New York Heimies?
The St. Louis Sambos.
How long do you think that would happen?
Not very long.
I like that.
Not in a heartbeat.
Come on.
But because Native Americans have no power and no real representation. And have been hosed big time from day one. You ever been to an Indian reservation? It's a disgrace.
Yeah, get cleaned up and get a job.
Shut up.
Get up the mud.
And one of the problems they have, out in the big reservation in the Navajo reservation, is they just got rid of Peter McDonald, such as it's their own people.
Yeah.
Well,
that's
a scam,
know. Yeah.
But, I mean, I don't need some punk to write a letter to the FCC about something like this when this is not really an issue. And the FCC is going to reprimand me.
No,
they're not. There's no reason to. I'd be happy to send anybody a tape who wants one of the conversation between me and Trump. Wasn't even about that. You know, Trump has 3 casinos in New Jersey. Of course, he doesn't want anybody to build a casino there. So, you know, protecting his interests.
It's a joke, folks. That's all it, you know.
This is not some concentrated effort to disparage or demean Native Americans. God, shut up
or
about
anybody
it.
Else. Come on.
I must make them joke.
That's exactly right.
That's all.
Many moon come joke. And who's this guy? Here's who's complaining.
This guy is Timothy Wapato, who's the...
The Imus in the Morning program began broadcasting in Massachusetts, giving Imus an entree to my home state constituents and an opportunity to dredge up, let me rephrase that, to remind them of an unfortunate incident in which I was involved there many years ago. Imus thought it amusing to play the recorded sounds of a car crash followed by a gurgling noise whenever my name was mentioned. Sophomoric and callow, but limited, I believed, to his antics in Boston, providing me a haven from his insolence in Washington. Regrettably, circumstances have changed. And similar to a herpes recurrence, he has now broken out here in Washington, giving me no respite. Now, I don't intend to be his helpmate. Therefore, I resolve never to have my name uttered here or any other place for that matter if I can help it, denying him the trigger, so to speak, for that inane sound effect. I'll simply be known as a prominent Massachusetts legislator. No name, title, or any specific identification.
Telephone for Senator Kennedy.
Oh, no.
Senator Kennedy.
No. Look, just hand me a note, okay? So this moron can't do that anymore? Is that so hard? My voice is instantly recognizable. So, actually, I need not say my name at all. And certainly under these intolerable Imus circumstances, with this bastard both in Boston and Washington now, I do not intend to do so. So, ask not my name.
Sir,
ask rather my...
I have a baggage for you.
Oh, really? Okay, fine.
Just initial for me and then sign your name right there.
Here?
That's right, sir. Underwood, your name is tied.
But this says Senator John Kerry.
That's right, sir. Just sign your name.
Yes, but I'm Senator Ted Kennedy. Oh, sh...
Ken Griffey Jr. of the Mariners knocked the Yanks out of first. Good morning. This is Mike Breen with Sports. Chip Carey with the call. Yankees lose and Baltimore wins, so the Orioles now lead the... Harris is the type of pitcher that gives the Mets trouble.
We don't hit the breaking ball guys real good. We can handle guys with fastballs a little bit, but we don't hit the breaking balls real good.
Unfortunately for Green and the Mets, there are a number of pitchers in the major leagues that throw breaking balls. Phillies, meanwhile, top the Dodgers in Los Angeles. 8-2, Len Dykstra with a home run and 3 RBI.
Gave me the manuscript to his new novel to read.
Right.
And I don't have the ending.
Oh. Give me the ending of your book or I'll kill your...
Blank cat.
Blank cat. That's a little strong.
But I constructed a
ransom note on my Apple computer.
Right.
On my Apple PowerBook.
I don't think this is what this was designed for.
Hey, by the way, Bernard, get a hold of...
515-0000-5852.
Okay, what's the expiration date on that?
Where do they have it on here?
It would be down in the lower right-hand corner. Or in the left-hand corner.
Lower left-hand.
In the middle. The top. On the side in the back somewhere. It's there.
I'm looking pretty hard.
Yeah, okay. Let me punch this up in the computer just a second here.
Okay.
All right, what's the designation on the on your bill for this charge? What is it? How much is the charge?
It's $6.18.
Right.
And it's like a phone number or something. And I just can't figure out what it is.
All right, just a minute. Let me see if I can get this. All right, that's a, well, how to say this? That is a charge for a, a phone sex line, a 970 sex line number.
It's a what? It's a sex line phone call? Is that what you're saying?
970 hump we have here.
When you say 970 hump, I don't know what you mean.
I don't either, ma'am. All I know is that's a designation we have on the bill here, 970 hump, that he apparently called. And
it's one of these, in other words, this number 415, do you have that?
Ma'am.
What?
Let me tell you something here. You have,
This is embarrassing.
I know it is.
I'm not going to tell my boss.
Well, you're not.
I'm not going to tell him.
No, you're not. I'll tell you why, because, where are you now?
Washington, D.C.
Have you ever heard of Imus in the morning?
What is it called?
Imus in the
morning.
No. He's a disc jockey in New York.
Uh-huh.
That's me.
You're a disc jockey in New York?
Yeah, on WFAN here in New York, and we're on the air now, as a matter of fact, and we've been talking on the air. And see, we have an 800, is this the 800 number, Bernie?
Yes, it is.
We have an 800 number here, and people get wrong numbers once in a while, and you got the wrong number, so your boss didn't call 970-HUMP.
Call the
hump.
This is ridiculous.
Well, I'm not the one who placed the call. We just thought, well, we, you know. Well, then she got, you know.
Why not make a little exercise?
Just a bit.
Remember the lady from Atlanta who called?
Oh, yeah.
I told this poor woman from Atlanta, talked to Mr. Marshall.
Yeah.
I told her that she had a $16,000 on her Visa card.
Includes the entertainment and revenue-generating portion of your broadcast day. WFAN New York and the Unistar Radio Network now return you to the rest of your local programming schedule. An indecipherable embarrassment of broadcasting incompetence that compelled this station to subscribe to the Imus in the Morning program in the first place in order to stave off bankruptcy, to prevent this frequency from going dark in your local listening area, and to avoid suicides among principals who were deceived into investing in a fiasco that is on the precipice of financial collapse and the subject of local Chamber of Commerce ridicule. The entertainment and revenue-generating portion of the broadcast day, the Imus in the Morning program, will resume tomorrow morning. Check your local listings for time and schedule.
With sports scores and sports news.
Greens right now. That's what's happening. I'm Mike Breen, WFAN 2020 Sports, the number one sports voice in New York.
Good morning, everybody. It is 10:04 on the Fan. Mike Lupica with you.
Len Berman on the Fan. Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York. Sports Radio 66, the Fan. Well, it's a great day for baseball, isn't it? Yankees home this afternoon. Mets playing this Sports Radio 66.
Before 10, Howie Rose.
They've been through enough tragedy over the last month or so, really just dating all the way back to spring training, in fact, since Tim Cruz, a former Dodger, they still wear his uniform number on their sleeve. And we'll talk to Dodgers general manager Fred Clare right after the update with Phil Daughtry. So you come on back, huh? Radio,
radio. Watching with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the number one sports voice in New York.
On the fan, Howie Rose with you up until midnight tonight, and your phone call still to come at 718-937-6666. We will get back to the phones in short enough order, although right now what we want to do is... ...1027, Howie Rose with you until midnight, heading back to the phones.
I love Jeff Greenfield. He's got a lot to offer. Back. I'm nervous. I'm really worried.
It's a problem.
I don't know if I can compete with guests like Tim Russert. He was spellbinding.
Shut up.
Wow, what a week you're having. Him, Sally Quinn. We have lined up for tomorrow. George Will. He should be good for a good yucks. Guys who wear bow ties, they're usually the best guests. Hey, why don't you make more hysterical references to Maureen Orth? Oh, but wait a second. She's married to Tim Russert. Oh, my size. How do you do it? What a caution you are.
Ooh, baby. Give me a million hamburgers, baby. How you naked, baby? How you donkey cock, baby?
I miss in the morning. 2020 Sports. Nancy Lopez is set to tee off. Lopez addresses the ball, goes into her backswing, and...
Unibay!
Right down the middle. The perfect throw for Nancy Lopez.
Women's U.S. Open Golf Championship underway in Indiana. Good morning. This is Mike Breen with sports. The ladies teeing off this morning. One of the favorites is Nancy Lopez.
How upset people were, that some people, that I was attacking this fathead at the station in Washington, Benazir. It's a joke.
Yes, he is a jerk, but... an empty suit. And not getting it done and nearly ruined the radio station.
Yeah, but essentially, you're right.
And not to ever make a mistake.
If we make a mistake, just say what happened rather than give me some elaborate lame-o excuse.
And then everything's fine, right?
I just don't want to hear about that. If Lou misses something and says, I forgot, what do I normally say?
You idiot!
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on The Fan.
And we're looking on we're looking at David Hackworth and Senator Edward Kennedy.
Yeah.
Really? And a current events quiz for Congressman Joe Kennedy.
How long does it take for somebody to drown when they're...
I'll take a pass on that one.
In the morning, 2020 Sports.
And now the stretch by Key, the 3-0 pitch to Tino Martinez. Swung on and belted deep to right field, and it's a three-run home run. My, oh my, they turned Tino loose just like Ron and I guessed, and Tino takes him downtown, and the Mariners lead it 6-3.
Yankees beaten by the long ball. Good morning, Mike Breen with sports. Dave Niehaus with the call on the Mariners Radio Network.
Well, that's a baseball
you
call.
You bet.
It was terrific.
Yeah.
Great. Certainly a lot better than yours.
Well, I need a little work, that's all.
You, man, boy, you've got a long way to go. Maybe you should have a Beck's beer before you do that next time. Oh, and by the way, Mike, this very hopefully fine sportscast is sponsored by Beck's beer.
Wow.
It's nice to know. Things on his mind, doesn't the Cardinal?
He's got that big priest problem.
Believe me, I've tried to get the Cardinal to write something and come in and perform it.
Do you want to know, I came up 95 from Myrtle Beach and I stopped over in Fredericksburg, Virginia. I didn't catch his show because we got up late. But I got some of the feedback from some of the people who called in the sports show after.
Mm-hmm.
Some very good, some okay, and a whole bunch of sucks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Eat the food, I'm begging you.
Well, I just figured that you'd be...
Tampa, Florida, and on, offending indiscriminately, and yet at the same time somehow being posted to the office of lapdog to the meretricious population of our power elite. Just short weeks ago, we were certain that the Imus ego surely had reached the physical limitations of its possible expansion. We could not have been more wrong.
No.
For with the phenomenon of syndication, the Imus ego is now in a f***ing meltdown of self-absorption. And who is most responsible for the disaster?
To this point, it has to be Mary Matlin and Gene Wallace, the co-hosts of a not-quite-ready-for-prime-time interview program on the Columbia School of Broadcasting Network, CNBC, a program which turned into little more than a phone sex exercise when the two lavished their attentions on Imus recently during an episode that should have been set in a massage parlor. Matlin, at least until now, has been the frequent consort of James Carville, the political guru who bears such an uncanny resemblance to the character Butthead of Beavis and Butthead, or in the view of others, to a lobotomy victim who just smelled a fart. But after Ms. Madeline's salacious, groveling interrogation of Mr. Imus, Carville, I'd suspect, is history. Or implicit in Matlin's remarks to Imus, the exaggerated wetting of the lips with the tongue, the slitting of the eyes, the frequent adjustments of the skirt to expose expanses of thigh, was the unstated phrase, "I, man, bind me to a four-poster and make me scream the names of men I've never met." Co-host Wallace, equally lustful, if not more so, gazed into the camera at Imus with the unmistakable look of a woman in full bloom, who, sufficiently motivated, could suck a bowling ball through a fire hose. And the way the ample Wallace panted toward Imus, it seemed clear to this seasoned journalist that he was indeed providing her with the necessary motivation at that moment. Certainly, it's all very mysterious, this Imus allure. Yeah. But there are things that we humans simply are not equipped to understand. The fact is, though, that with Madeline, Wallace, Anna Quinlan, and so many other myopic women now describing New York's I-Man as a hunk, it's perhaps time a new item was added to the product inventory of nascent entrepreneur and I-Man sibling Fred Imus, the four-color designer Auto Body Express El Paso condom. But perhaps this promotional slogan, "Before you're bred, cap the head with a rubber from Fred." For Media Watch, this is Walter Cronkite. Good night.
Earlier this morning, we were...
You know, I really appreciate Dave Checkers and the Knicks recognizing and really rewarding me for my contributions to the organization. And today they changed my title and promoted me to vice president and general manager.
The Knicks' Ernie Grunfeld on the fan yesterday after his promotion. Good morning. This is Mike Breen with sports.
Listen, Ernie Grunfeld.
New York.
And good morning, everybody. It is 10:05 on the fan. Mike Ludwicker with you.
20 sports on WFAN.
Put your headphones on so you can hear me say,
the home of Iron Eagle and the number one sports voice in New York.
Six on the fan. Welcome back. Iron Eagle, the Birdman, taking you until 10 o'clock. Mets baseball is coming up. The New York Mets in Los Angeles to face off against the Dodgers.
Guys, and that's what's happening. I'm Bill Daughtry with 2020 Sports on WFAN, the number one sports voice in New York.
And New York City, Steve Summers here. You there, Sweeney Murphy on the other side of the glass, 718-937-6666, number to call as we continue overnight under the covers, cruising Sinesky RGS with you in the Limus in the morning at 5:30 right here on your fan, New York City.
Sports Radio, Sports Voice in New York. 1993 New York Jets.
Well, morning to you, and how you be at 3:07 and 10 seconds on a Friday morning on the fan, New York City. Steve Summers here, you there. Sweeney Murphy on the other side of the glass, 718-937-6666. Number to call as we continue overnight under the covers, cruising SunSPORTS with you until I miss in the morning at 5:30, right here on your fan, New York City. Because we have come on a little bit later than usual, just a few spots to get out of the way, and this one we'll do as quickly as possible. LV brand, of course, don't you think that's the way the sponsor likes it? LV469, for those keeping score at home, I know you are, if you are going to the Hamptons.
Since your actual debut in our capital, I'm us in the morning. Oh, I wish I could be more enthusiastic, as the occasion warrants, but...
Well, I'm really bummed, Nyman. In the dumper.
What's the matter?
Well, I hear the Wall Street Journal is getting ready to do an editorial on me.
Shut up.
I don't know. You wouldn't happen to have a vacuum hose and a tailpipe handy, would you? I can't take the pressure.
Idiot.
You know, come to think of it, when they operated an old Conway Twitty there, they found little undigested bits of herd on the street in it. Did you know that? Now, you're already on the edge, Imo, so if Paul Steiger should call you and say, hey, Dono, we'd like to do a piece on you for Leisure and Arts, take a pass, okay? You're the franchise, J.D.
Yeah.
Issue one, by the way, happens to be people we'd like to see the journal take on editorially, okay? How about, Sheikh Abdul Omar Rahman? He'd be one. And Bob Costas, there's another.
Yeah.
Let's see, Bennett Zier, the empty suit who runs your Washington affiliate. He's in there.
Yeah.
Oh, and Ross Perot. We'd like to see a lengthy piece on that mindless dwarf. How about Woody Allen and that China woman who's attached to his hip?
Well.
And oh, speaking of that, guess who Dan Rather would pay to see treated in a Wall Street Journal editorial?
Well.
Three guesses. The first two don't count. Connie Chung. I'll tell you, in my long and for the most part successful political career, I became an adroit student of body language, as you know. Now, I've been taking careful note of the physical messages Dan is sending Connie in the past several shows, and clearly, they seem to be saying just one thing.
And that would be...
Die! Back on the boat, Ling Ling, you're killing me. They started out, you'll recall, sitting so close together that I thought she wasn't going to have to worry anymore about Maury getting her pregnant. Well, now they're a yard apart.
Right.
And we're about one more dead last rating book away from having him jabbing at her with a pair of sharpened chopsticks, for crying out loud. All right, issue, three?
Yeah.
Whatever. Ruth Bader Ginsburg, Supreme Court nominee. I'm sitting there, I-Man, watching her responses, and I'm thinking, brilliant nominee. Not only a woman, not only Jewish, but in a particularly bold move, the first Supreme Court nominee with Alzheimer's. God almighty, Kiki. Subject, verb, predicate, string them together, okay? Jesus. Issue four, Joycelyn Elders, M.D.,
yeah.
And another interesting Bill Clinton nominee.
Right.
Here's my thought. Shouldn't the Surgeon General, the nation's health advocate, look like she'd maybe even walked by a f***ing gym at some time in her life? She looks like a blowfish. And her blood pressure must be like, Roger Ailes' waist dimension over Rose Kennedy's age. 911 for Suzanne Summers. Send this chick a mercy thighmaster, okay? Oh, quickly as I conclude, happy birthday, I nearly forgot, to the Kennedy matriarch. Although, a terrible thing about the fire there at Hyannisport. Looked like Waco, didn't it?
Wasn't any fire. That was her birthday cake.
Oh, my mistake. I thought the whole damn thing burned to the ground.
No.
Or maybe some ATF boys out of Janet Reno's office were there working the barbecue pit or something. Not the first time I've been wrong, I readily admit it. I was really wrong when I didn't have Janet Reno in my administration in charge of those f***ing tapes. Hell, Reno and little Sterno, and who knows, I might very well still be president of the United States.
Southport, Connecticut, as many of you know.
So I was taking the dog out for his morning walk like I do every day.
Mm-hmm.
And we're over there on your front lawn, you know. And as he squats down by your front steps, I suddenly remember something. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. I hope it's your last one. So you're going to have them sent directly to your house? You're going to go down and pick them up every month?
What are you talking about?
Your Social Security check. Should be pretty hefty, since you've been paying it with since Roosevelt was in office. And I'm talking Teddy here.
Fine.
Come on, admit it. You're already past the dog track. You're ready for the drool cup. You know, I used to think it was because you were from the Southwest, but now I realize it's your age that makes your face look like it's made out of adobe. I'm surprised you're in a small Native American family living in that sinkhole on your cheek.
Shut up.
But I didn't know what to get you for your birthday, stupid. I was toying with the idea of getting that Ron Popeil beef jerky machine, but I didn't know if you were into skincare, so I decided just to go with something that really sums up my personal feelings about you.
Mm-hmm.
It's over there by your front stoop. Needless to say, I didn't wrap it.
Finger, which is one of those songs that suffers greatly from a lack of hallucinogenics in the system of the listener. Man, when I think about what would have happened had Just Say No been around during the 60s, we wouldn't have all these Electric Prunes and Sup with Camel albums laying around today. Well, the big news this summer, I guess, is Glenn Campbell taking a group along to do a Wet Aid thingy for the folks in the Midwest. Got Tony Orlando and Wayne Newton with them. Jesus, haven't these people suffered enough? Like sitting on the roof waiting for a rowboat isn't already an ordeal. They're going to have to sit through a 20-minute sing-along version of Tie a Yellow Ribbon. I saw Tony on E going, you know, I want to do everything I can to help out these folks going through this high water thing. I can only hope that this pant load is standing knee-deep in the big muddy when he grabs hold of the microphone. Speaking of microphones, Darth Vader Ginsburg's been sitting in front of one a lot lately for the confirmation hearings. Man, is this old crone scary looking enough? I mean, she puts on the black robe and all she's missing is the pointy hat. I'll get you, my pretty, and your little dog, too. Well, at least there's one justice we know who won't be getting hit on by Clarence Thomas. I don't quite understand this whole confirmation process. Yeah. I mean, I can see wanting to put a candidate for the Supreme Court on the spot in terms of political and philosophical points of view, how their personal feelings on issues would affect their ability to perform their job as a justice.
Yeah.
But I saw somebody ask her if she'd read any good books lately. What's next? You're going to ask her what her favorite color is? Joe Biden acts like he's Burt Parks. What's next? The evening gown and swimsuit competition? You're going to have Ruth recite the Roe v. Wade decision while she twirls a baton and tap dances? And what's the deal with Arlen Specter?
No, no.
What is it, funny hat day in the Senate?
Shut up.
He looks like he just got back from vacation.
No, no. He just got out of the hospital. He had a brain tumor removed.
Oh, so I guess that explains why he came down so hard on Anita Hill.
No,
all that pressure backing up, you know,
no.
Getting a bad headache. All this time, I thought it was just too much caffeine.
Shut up. Just please shut up.
Why don't we do it in the road?
After 9 o'clock.
All right, here now on the Imus of Morning program, nationally syndicated gossip columnist.
Today, with a matter of national importance, a warning. A call to arms regarding a threat of biblical proportions. There is a cancer which has metastasized, transmitted from one site within our boundaries to other points throughout the United States, and settled in the philosophical center of our republic, contaminating the capital of the United States. No, I don't mean the president. I'm talking about an even greater evil, the infection known as Imus. You know, I thought it was pretty strange when a little more than a year ago, Bill Clinton, on the eve of the New York primary, was dead in the water, floating ineffectually, like medical waste off the coast of Coney Island, until one seemingly innocent phone call to a sophomoric radio program helmed by an intellectual infant jump-started the campaign. Now, I used to think it was Imus's fault that Bubba got elected. But now I realize the election of Bill Clinton was only the means to a far more diabolical end. The entree of Imus into the Washington market. It was a conspiracy. The payback for the timely endorsement in New York was a key that unlocked the door to a situation wherein this subversive aberration can utilize his embarrassingly limited options to influence political thought. I can see it now. Every limo on the Beltway turned to the AM frequency. His boorish baritone piped into the restrooms of the Senate and the House. Filibusters on the floor rife with Imus vernacular. Na-na-na-na-na. Sounds like the blues. Have a salad, you pantload. Just as stalwart public servants, Robert Dole, Bill Bradley, Lowell Weicker, Mario Cuomo, Al D'Amato, and President William Rodham Clinton himself have fallen into the web of iniquity known as Imus. Others are poised on the precipice of being consumed themselves. Jump on the eye wagon, or run the risk of hearing on the radio how you're not getting it done. The Emperor's new clothes, an Autobody Express El Paso, Texas t-shirt, red polo windbreaker, and Nike running shoes. And what's worse is, I'm afraid we're too late to do anything about it. There is nothing we can do to protect ourselves from the venereal disease that has planted itself at the brainstem of our country. Short of pulling a giant condom over the Washington Monument and a dental dam around the Capitol Rotunda, this is a plague which threatens irreparable damage to the District of Columbia. Imagine taking a leisurely stroll through the mall during cherry blossom season, the pink petals floating delicately downwards, until they rest upon the reflecting pool. You climb the stairs of the Lincoln Memorial, anticipating the patriotic thrill of seeing the majestic marble sculpture, and find instead a hideous Imus bobblehead doll. More after this.
This is to help you all along on your way to the rush room. The man saying,
well, I don't care what you think, but liberals stink, and Democrats almost as lame. All those Negroes and Jews, they give me the blues. Our country's dying, and Clinton's to blame. The Monopsies are wrong, and they don't belong in my conservative-minded domain. But let's call a truce. Stick your head in this noose, and don't let me hear you complain. 'Cause I like friends with white faces and a burning cross that you know chases those Jews away. Then we call it a day. Oh, we're mighty big on the master races. We wear slip-on sheets and pillowcases. Oh, I like friends. Show them what an axe handle's for. You wouldn't believe what we did to this heap. Painted swastikas on his front door. I'm proud as can be, 'cause the whole EIB think I could be president someday. But I'm just a man of letters, you see, and they all spell KKK. And a burning cross that you know chases those Jews away. Then we call it a day. Oh, we're mighty big on the master races. We wear slip-on sheets and pillowcases. Oh, I like friends with white.
Somebody out. course, Ricky had something to say about the incident after the game.
He was serious on what he was saying. I guess he was upset, so he had to be serious on what he was saying. I really don't recall exactly what he said, but I don't really let that get to me. You know, I guess if we go out there and he threatened me and he hit me like that, I just got to go out there and respect myself and be a man and go out there and kick his butt. That's all.
Entertainment and revenue generating portion of your broadcast day. WFAN New York and the Unistar Radio Network now return you to the rest of your local programming schedule. An indecipherable embarrassment of broadcasting incompetence that compelled this station to subscribe to the Imus in the Morning program in the first place. In order to stave off bankruptcy, to prevent this frequency from going dark in your local listening area, and to avoid suicides among principals who were deceived into investing in a fiasco that is on the precipice of financial collapse and the subject of local Chamber of Commerce ridicule. The entertainment and revenue-generating portion of the broadcast day, the Imus in the Morning program, will resume Monday morning. Check your local listings for time and schedule. 2020 Sports on the Fan means you'll get all the scores and sports news every 20 minutes. At the time...
Freeze right now. That's what's happening. I'm Mike Breen, WFAN 2020 Sports, the number one sports voice in New York.
What do you say? Howie Rose with you on the Fan up to 2 o'clock this afternoon when Mike Brown...
For a real...
We're sneaking up on 11 o'clock on the Fan. Howie Rose with you moving towards 2 o'clock when Mike Francesa skips in solo once again, as he will be for the next week. And we will also have a chance to chat with Walter Payton and Ron Hextall, as well as Ed Coleman between now and 2 o'clock. Plus your phone calls at 718-937-6666. So stick around. We'll be back after the flash.
Sports Radio.
Sports score.
I'm Mike Breen, WFAN 2020 Sports, the number one sports voice in New York.
Hi, everybody. This is Howie Rose on the Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN in New York.
Sports Radio 66, the Fan, WFAN, New York. 11:04 on the Fan. Howie Rose here, working towards 2 o'clock. And Mike Francesa time. We've got plenty of time to go to the phones for the next little bit. It's 7-1.
Mike and the Mad Dog, Sports Radio 66, WFAN.
Hi, I'm Howie Rose. Why don't you make sure to listen to my show tomorrow morning for your chance to win a...
On Sports Radio WFAN.
Francesa on the Fan, 4:47 on a busy Friday. Be here.
On the Fan, Iron Eagle taking you until 10 o'clock. Let's get spit and vinegar all over the place. Saberhagen of Blue Jay. I'm sure Toronto would want to talk to the Mets again. It's worked for four for Pat Gillick. Daughtry's next.
Sports Radio.
On the Fan, Ian Eagle soaring with you until 10 o'clock. Mets pregame show comes your way then. It's the Mets and the Dodgers out on the West Coast. Frank Tanana, 30 seconds to wrap up exactly what he's meant to the ball club, but he's been there, he's been consistent, he's struggled over the last 2 years, and it leaves that bad taste in your mouth when you think about Hojo, but he had some pretty big years with the New York Mets. Thanks to Brian Walsh, Lisa Johnson, this is Ian Eagle. I will talk to you tomorrow night after the Met game. Stay tuned to the Fan.
Sports Radio 66, the Fan, WFAN.
Hey, sports fans.
Sports in New York.
With you on the fan till 1 o'clock this morning with, or this afternoon anyhow, with Bagels and Baseball. We get plenty of chances to talk to you on the phones at 7-1.
You marry him.
But it wouldn't be so bad. He kind of looks like a chick.
Yeah, like those chicks in Nelson, if they stayed in the sun for about a year.
What's that thing on his neck? That's cool.
That is his neck. You're such a weed.
Come on, when's he going to put that traffic chick on?
Yeah, she's cool. She looks like Ozzy Osbourne with more tattoos.
Let's go eat some cabbage and beans, sit in the tub and play jacuzzi.
I have a better idea. Let's play Electric Kitty. We'll get a cat, throw it in your pool, and then drop the radio in it.
Cool.
Hey, hey, mama, said the way you move, gon' make you slap.
Before 1 o'clock, Howie Rose with you until 2. All this Vince Coleman stuff has reminded me.
Who's on hold, Bernard?
That's Rob Bartlett.
What do you want, Rob?
Don't ever call me and ask me for computer advice again.
I know how to run my computer.
Yeah, that's why I get a phone call every night at 11 o'clock.
No, because I can't help it.
There's smoke coming out of the back. Is that bad?
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
And the idiot who sold it to me, David Teodosio, where is he?
He's golfing.
This is a nitwit with 8 earrings and a ponytail. So if he should sell me this Apple Power Book, which I'm going to throw in the...
Hey, dude, this is the one you really want, okay?
Yeah, that's exactly how it is.
It's the most expensive, and you'll have to buy another one in about a week.
In the morning.
Say Howard Stern to somebody like that is.
I don't even know who that guy is.
We called your losers there, Todd Dingleberry and these other people every day.
Wait a minute. You said you like Todd.
I do, but we talked to the people in Boston and Providence and Scranton and Tampa to make sure everything's going fine.
Right.
We're trying to help you. What are you doing? You're working against us.
Right. Okay, wait. Let me show. Imus, I'm happy.
This concludes the entertainment and revenue-generating portion of your broadcast day. WFAN New York and the Unistar Radio Network now return you to the rest of your local programming schedule, an indecipherable embarrassment of broadcasting incompetence that compelled the station to subscribe to the Imus in the Morning program in the first place in order to stave off bankruptcy, to prevent this frequency from going dark in your local listening area, and to avoid suicides among principals who were deceived into investing in a fiasco that is on the precipice of financial collapse and the subject of local Chamber of Commerce ridicule. The entertainment and revenue-generating portion of the broadcast day, the Imus in the Morning program, will resume tomorrow morning. Check your local listings for time and schedule.
Imus in the Morning.
This is TC Modem, the computer genius from CompUSA.
the dartboard company, they have my...
One of the great... newspapers in this country, the Washington Post.
I've always said that, whether I was in it or not.
Let me tell you something.
This woman did this, Paula Spann. If she, for someone you know, Miss Boston Celtics, the NBA, in fact, mankind.
And the consciousness examined is increasingly strange. Today we have the phenomenon of an entire media apparatus, the Washington Press Corps, psychoanalyzing those who roam the corridors of power. We hear from self-appointed experts bemoaning something they define as the politics of nastiness, its causes, its effects, as though rough-and-tumble politics were some newfangled notion, causing its victims to crumble and crack. Yeah. Well, it's not, nor is it unique to Washington, D.C. Inside the Beltway, it's mudslinging and character assassination. Outside the Beltway, it's name-calling and gossip-mongering. And some people can take it, and some people develop great fault lines that cause them to set that final picnic table in the park. Believe me, the stress level of Washington, D.C. is no worse than that experienced by some homie named Julio, dodging AK-47 drive-by boys in the barrio every day. go dribble sympathy sop.
Yeah.
Next, to the press's approach to the latest corruption in Congress. When is somebody going to step up and tell it like it is? Dan Rostenkowski, the chairman of the House Ways and Means Committee, is a fat, thieving pickpocket, using your taxes to run what's probably a Chicago bathhouse and his access to privilege in Congress to keep him in walking around money. This weasel can't be let out in leg restraints with his raincoat over his head soon enough to suit me. Next, Willie Nelson, country balladeer with a Chinese fruit braid hanging off the back of his head. The press has nearly deified Willie for presenting $20,000 to the Midwest flood relief effort. Brand me the cynic, but I say jump change and ask, where's the rest of the money, you snaggletooth dork? Are you Willie Nelson or Willie Sutton, for crying out loud? With Media Watch, this is Walter Cronkite. Good night.
This is PC Motor.
Versed on what went on with Reggie Lewis. That's the story of the day. Unfortunately, his untimely passing, far too young.
Mike and the Mad Dog, Sports Radio 66, WFAN.
94 degrees, sunny skies, and that's what's happening. This is Ian Eagle with 2020 Sports on WFAN. The number one sports voice in New York.
That's us on the Fan 307. We'll do a little more other things later on. Did against 11 top cardiologists.
Fine.
Hey, did you hear about what Angela did to her breasts? She had breast augmentation and something went awry.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. She's all right. Isn't she nothing like got her sick?
Yeah. One's pointing north, the other's pointing south. Well, no, but
it's
I mean...
It's not like a leak or anything.
No.
They're hanging off her back.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on the Fan.
I went out with a woman one time who had these silicone deals.
Uh-huh.
And it's like licking on a beach ball.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying? I mean, they feel different.
What was her name?
No, they feel different.
Touching the breasts?
No, he just hadn't blown her up enough.
Radio 66, WFAN New York, WFAN 2020 Sports.
It's 4 o'clock. This is Ian Eagle.
But I looked at him.
And the number one sports voice in New York.
Hi, 406 for Ancestor on the Fan Dog on vacation. That's what a fan. 507. Yankees win. Yanks win. Yanks win.
Sweeney Murgee on the other side of the glass. 718-937-6666. Number to call. As we continue overnight, under your covers, under the covers, schmoozing some SPO. How rude of me. 718-937-6666. Before I this morning, further on the Pentagon.
I've talked to Rick in Providence, by the way, and a lot of folks calling up trying to defend the I-Man.
What do you mean, calling?
That was you calling? It was down the newsroom. Made like 19 calls.
Did you?
Disguised my voice each time.
I think he's really great. Keep him on the air.
I miss music.
Running with the lesbian. I like Imus.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on the Fan. Imus in the Morning, 2020 Sports.
Nancy Lopez sent to Dion. Lopez addresses the ball, goes into a backswing, and...
Shoot a man!
Right down the middle. Perfect drop for Nancy Lopez.
Change your destination.
Well, morning to you, and how you be? The 3:07 and 5 seconds on a Thursday morning on the Fan, New York City. Steve Summers here, you there. Sweeney Murchie on the other side of the glass, 718-937-6666. Number to call as we continue overnight under the covers. Schmoozing some SPRTS with you. Till I miss in the morning at 5:30 right here on the Fan, New York City. Comes from the sports.
Well, all eyes are on this young man right now as he stands in. Griffey 0-2 tonight. And the first pitch from Banks is one. There it goes! See you later! Upper deck! Griffey has tied the Major League record! Holy cow, the kid has done it! Home runs in 8 consecutive games!
Exciting record-breaking night of the...
I mean, this is so bogus, it makes my skin crawl.
Although it's now under investigation, Griffey tied Don Mattingly and Dale Long for hitting a home run in 8 consecutive games.
How corrupt is the former America's pastime? How corrupt has it become when we have punks like Vince Coleman and that slug, gutless, worm-gut-sucking, panty-sniffing stooge, can't-suck-enough Bobby Bonilla, and dirtbag, and people like Eric David and these other scum. And even though Ken Griffey Jr. is a fine young man, it's reprehensible that they would groove a beach ball up there for him to take out of the park. Absolutely. I mean, come on here.
Well, Willie Banks, the pitcher for the Twins, who is...
Right away.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning on the Fan.
WFAN, Nancy speaking.
Nancy, oh, it's Imus.
Hi.
Most people here at the radio station, don't you think they like me?
No.
Don't hold back, baby.
You want to think about it for a sec?
How are you, Chris?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good. I'm taking a poll of people who work here at the station.
Okay.
It's my position that most people don't like Francesa, but do like me. Wouldn't you agree with that?
I like both of you. But I'm also on Xanax this morning, so I like everyone.
Acid indigestion.